Your business is live. Your QuickBooks Online account is set up. Great start. Now it's time to enter your opening balances. But wait, one small mistake here can seriously mess up your books. Here's what I see all the time. You're adding a new account, maybe you're checking with US Bank, and QuickBooks sweetly asks, "Wanna enter an opening balance?" And you say, "Sure, why not?" And bam, QuickBooks quietly sneaks that number into something called opening balance equity. And if you don't fix it, it just sits there, messing with your balance sheet and confusing everything. Don't worry, I'll show you how to do it right from the start. I'm Catherine Silverio, owner of Silver Bullet Bookkeeping, and in this video, I'll walk you through the right way to enter opening balances in QuickBooks, especially if your business is already up and running. I've got my screen split so you can follow along. On one side, QuickBooks is open with a zero balance sheet. On the other side, we've got an ending balances spreadsheet. And this is key. You'll want your ending balances from December 31st of the year before you're starting in QuickBooks. For example, since I'm setting this up for 2025, I'm working off balances from December 31st, 2024. You can grab those balances from your accountant, from last year's tax return, or your old accounting software, whatever gives you the clearest snapshot of where things stood. And I'll say this part twice because it is so important. Your opening balances in QuickBooks should reflect your actual balances as of the very last day of the previous year. For me, that means December 31st, 2024, so I can start fresh on January 1st, 2025. Think of it like turning the page to a new chapter. You're not rewriting history here. You're just making sure the story continues exactly where it left off. Using a journal entry is a more accurate method that keeps your books clear and clean, especially if your business is already up and running. Let's study the ending balance sheet. This is for my fictional aviation company, SkyTrails Aero Services. Checking. I'm going to highlight this yellow because this has a twist and it's a bit tricky. It has something to do with uncleared checks. So look here, I'm going to click the next page because I have other important information here. See, I have two uncleared checks. Let's go back to the first page. I have assets here, loans, and retained earnings. So this is important. Don't enter your accounts receivable and accounts payable or uncleared checks on the journal entry. You'll handle those separately to keep them linked to the right customers or vendors. I'm going to highlight these yellow too to show emphasis. Let's go to QuickBooks. Go to Add New on the left side of the screen. Under Other, click Journal Entry. Now remember, I'm in the year 2025, so my journal entry will be the last day of the previous year. I can't state that enough. So for me, it will be December 31st, 2024. Now right here under Journal Number, we can leave that as 1. But let's call this Opening Balance Entry. And by the way, this isn't an adjusting journal entry, so leave that unchecked if you have that small box on your screen. You're just building your starting point, not making adjustments to it, all right? Okay, now here's something key. We're only working with balance sheet accounts, your assets, liabilities, and equity. We are not entering any income or expense balances. Why? Because those accounts reset every year. All your revenue and expenses from last year get rolled into retained earnings on January 1st. So when you're setting up your opening balances, those accounts should all start at 0. I've created a mock balance sheet for my fictional company, SkyTrail Aero Services, but when you're doing it for your own books, make sure your actual numbers are accurate. The first thing, you can see here, we've got checking account for $22,000, accounts receivable $42,000. We have some other assets, and then we have accounts payable, loans, and retained earnings. Okay, and it all balances. Total assets, $75,500. Total liabilities and equity, $75,500. So these other information that I have here, let me flip the page, and you'll understand why this is important here in just a minute. You wanna look up on your final bank reconciliation, what uncleared items did you have? All right, so in this case, we have uncleared checks as of December 31st, 2024. For $1,200 and $50. These are the check numbers, 1976 and 1977. and here are your clients, John Davis and Emily Carter. Uncleared checks are checks you've written and recorded in your accounting system or checkbook, but haven't cleared the bank yet. In other words, the money hasn't officially left your bank account. Accounts receivable is made up of two different invoices, $20,000 and $22,000. So you can see that total equals $42,000 accounts receivable. And then accounts payable, as of December 31st, 2024, we have these vendors, Parker and Green, for $2,000 and $6,000. And that total of $8,000 equals our accounts payable. Okay, so we want to record those a little bit differently than the other accounts. And all this will come together in the end, I promise. And yes, you can absolutely do this yourself, especially if you're a hands-on small business owner who likes to be in control of the books. But if your head's starting to spin, or if you're thinking, I'd rather focus on growing my business than wrestling with journal entries and QuickBooks, I get it. That's exactly what I help with. I'm Catherine Silverio, owner of Silver Bullet Bookkeeping. And if you'd rather leave the bookkeeping to someone who actually enjoys this stuff, yeah, really, I'd love to help. Call or text to set up a free 30-minute discovery call. No pressure, just a friendly chat to see how I can make your life easier. Now, if you're still wondering, why can't I just plug everything into the journal entry and be done with it? Well, that's a great question. Let's break that down, because this part trips up a lot of people. Here's why it matters. For accounts receivable, if you just enter a journal entry for money customers owe you, QuickBooks won't know which customer it belongs to. So when you receive a payment, you won't be able to apply it to an invoice. Instead, enter the actual invoices into QuickBooks. That way, when the payment comes in, you can apply it directly to the correct customer. For accounts payable, same idea. If you enter just a journal entry showing that you owe $8,000, QuickBooks won't show any bills to pay. So instead, enter the actual bills into QuickBooks. That way, you'll be able to pay them properly and keep your vendor balances accurate. And for checking accounts, things work a bit differently too, especially if you have uncleared checks. You'll want to enter those checks so they show up when you do your first bank reconciliation in January 2025. That way, you can match them and make sure everything balances correctly. Okay, so let's walk through this step by step. So the first account is checking, and its balance is $22,000. All right, so if we go back over to QuickBooks, we are going to say checking. And now we have the $22,000, but hold on. We also have some uncleared checks, remember? All right, so we have uncleared checks of $1,200 and $50. So we say $22,000 plus $1,200 plus $50. That's $23,250. Now, you may be saying, well, why are you adding that to the balance? Because there are uncleared checks. The reason is because we're going to enter the checks into QuickBooks, and it'll bring that balance back down to the $22,000 where it should be. Okay? Follow me here. A debit increases the checking account. For the description, we're going to enter opening balances as of 1/1/2025. And for you, again, it'll be whatever year you're in. The next one is accounts receivable, but hold on, we don't want to enter anything for accounts receivable because we're going to enter those actual invoices. Okay, our next one is furniture and fixture for $10,000. Notice how it automatically populates $23,250 in the credit section? That's because it's trying to balance your accounts. As I mentioned before, debits and credits always have to balance each other out. In this case, furniture and fixture is actually still a debit. We're not completely done with our entry. And then you'll see that after I hit tab, it zeroed out the credit section, and it also brought in that same description down here below. Okay, the next one is aircraft and equipment, and that was $5,000. The next one was accumulated depreciation. So since that's a negative here, that's going to be a credit. So that's $4,000. Our next one is a security deposit of $500, and that's pretty straightforward. Next, we've got accounts payable, but again, just like accounts receivable, we're not going to enter that because we're going to enter the bills. All right, so let's go back over here. We'll say the next one is machinery loan for $3,000. So let me see what loans I have in SkyTrail Aero Services. We don't have that account yet, so we'll create one on the fly. Click Add New. Account name is Machinery Loan. Account number is 2400. Account type is Long-Term Liability. Detail type is Other Long-Term Liability. Now, all liabilities, to increase them, you do a credit. Just like with assets, you do a debit to increase. With liabilities, you do a credit to increase. All right, and then the last one here on the balance sheet is note payable for $11,000. Oops, now you'll notice there's a difference of $20,750. That amount is going to flow into retained earnings. Okay, so let's go here. Retained earnings, $20,750. You might be thinking, wait, this doesn't match the balance sheet I'm looking at. And that's totally fine. Don't worry, that's because we still need to enter a few more items to complete the picture. Once you do this, you're just going to hit save and close. It's going to say you're about to post to retained earnings. Are you sure you want to? It's okay. You click okay. If you see other prompts, just save anyway. All right. So let me pull up the balance sheet as of December 31st, 2024. Here's all our entries. We've got $23,250 of cash, our fixed assets, our loans, and our retained earnings. Now we have to get this balance sheet to match this balance sheet over here. So the next step is we want to enter these other items. So we have check 1976 for $1,200 and check 1977 for $50. All right, so let's go back over here. You're going to look up when you actually wrote those checks. All right, so let's say that this balance sheet is as of December 31st, 2024. Let's say it was December 15th. It's gotta be sometime before December 31st, 2024. So I'm going to click New. Under Vendors, click Check to write checks. I'm going to physically enter these checks. Who did you pay? John Davis. He isn't listed, so we'll create a vendor on the fly. So it's coming out of the checking account. All right, let me look at these check numbers again. This is check 1976. We wanna make sure that the date is correct. And you want to put it to the account that it's supposed to go to. Okay, so if this was an expense, we'll just say aircraft maintenance supplies. All right, we're not doing any class tracking, so let's save and new, save anyway. And now we want to do the next one, 1977. We'll change the date to 12/24/2024, and this one is to Emily Carter for $50. All right, so this one is for, we'll say that this is for, let's see, advertising and promotions, $50. Save and close. Okay, so we have our two checks. Let's go back to the balance sheet. You see now when I recorded those checks, it brought my checking balance down to $22,000. See how I was talking about before? You add those uncleared checks to your checking balance, and then when you enter the uncleared checks, it brings it back down to $22,000. Okay, are you feeling better? The next thing we have to do is go in and record those accounts receivable. To record our accounts receivable, we're going to click New. Then under Customers, go to Invoice. So let's go over here. We're going to see on our Create Invoices, we've got David Kim for $20,000. He isn't listed yet, so we'll create this new client. Add New, first and last name, then hit Save. You're going to enter the actual invoice number that you used. 1001. For terms, it's due on receipt. Enter the actual invoice date, which is 12/28/24, and you're going to put in all the details. We're going to say that this is $20,000 for services. Hit save and new. And the next one is going to be Michael Turner. Okay, this is going to be 12/30/2024. This is invoice number 1002, and we'll say this is for services again for $22,000. Make sure everything matches with your invoice. All right, so you see now we have our accounts receivable of $42,000 on our balance sheet. And when those clients pay, we can offset it directly against the invoice that we just recorded. If you enter accounts receivable as a journal entry instead of using invoices, QuickBooks won't know which customer owes you money. You won't be able to apply payments to specific invoices later, and your reports, like who still owes you, will be wrong. Using invoices keeps everything organized and accurate. Right, last step in making sure your balance sheet matches is to enter those accounts payable. So we're going to click New. Under Vendors, click Bill. As of 12/31/2024, we need to pay Parker and Green. All right, so the first one is Ethan Parker. Let's create this new vendor. First, last name, hit save. You put in the terms, net 15, the exact bill date, 12/26/24, and it was for $2,000. We're going to say that this was for ground transportation. Hit save and new. Then this last one is to Tyler Green for $6,000. Let's add him as well. The date is 12/29/24. Invoice number, let's copy and paste that. And that's for $6,000, okay. And hangar rent, all looks good. Save and close. Okay, so now we entered all our accounts payable, all our accounts receivable, and all the uncleared checks. Once all that's in, run a balance sheet report and compare it to your original one. Everything should line up perfectly. Yes, it does. Congrats. Now we can start entering things as of January 1st, 2025, or the current year you're in. So why does this matter? Well, if you just use the opening balance fields as you're creating your chart of accounts, your books might technically balance, but they won't be accurate. You won't be able to track who owes you money, who you owe, or properly reconcile bank statements. Doing it the right way, though it takes a little more time, sets you up with clean, traceable books going forward. Your CPA will thank you. If you found this helpful, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any future videos. Here's to clear skies and clean books. This is Catherine signing off from Silver Bullet Bookkeeping.